Welcome to worship at Our Savior's Feet in Church, and welcome to everyone who's joining us on the radio, TV, or online. For today's service, we are worshiping in the courtyard at Our Savior's Feet in Church. Pastor Joe and I thought that this would be a very appropriate space for us to have this service, as it is the first space that you see when you enter Our Savior's Feet in Church building and the place that you leave from. This is the last service that I will be part of as your called pastor. So this is the first place that I entered and the first and the last place that I will be leaving. The first time that I was in the courtyard was years before I came to interview here or to serve here, as I served a neighboring parish not too far from here. And so I've been in here for meetings and so forth. But I do remember the feeling coming in. And this is just a very impressionable space. It reminds me of European street, cobbled streets. And I can remember thinking, oh, I wonder what the rest of the building looks like, because this is just such an awesome place and a wonderful kind of hospitality gathering place. And I wonder what happens, because this is a good-sized building. Up on the third floor, downstairs, up those stairs, and through into the dining room. Well, now I know. I know all the things that happen in all the different corners of this building, and all of it for the good of the gospel, all of it for supporting the members here and sending out from this courtyard. I thank you for these last almost 4 years of ministry together, and I'm going to miss you, and I take you with me, and I thank you for the memories. Later today, I invite you to a drive-up farewell open house across the street along Caledonia. I'm in front of the parsonage, which has been my home for almost 4 years, from 4 to 7. So I hope to see many of you there. Pastor Joe, do you have anything else to add in the way of announcements?
I do. And again, that drive-by open house is happening today. To be able to wish Pastor Julie farewell and good luck. And of course, there's also some grieving, as you can hear in our voices, of a transition. And no doubt some of you are grieving as well. We're excited, but in the midst of excitement, there is also grief. And so to be able to express both of those things, grief and celebration, with Pastor Julie, that drive-by open house is today from 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock. Also happening in a drive-by fashion, on August 23rd, we're going to have drive-by communion. That was originally scheduled for today, but we really wanted the attention to be on Pastor Julie's open house. So on Sunday, August 23rd, we'll do a drive-by worship service. We'll still have our online television and radio broadcast at 9:30, and from 10:30 to 11:30 on August 23rd, we'll be right in front of the church, Our Savior's Lutheran Church in Hillsboro on Caledonia Avenue, for a drive-by communion opportunity. Also coming up for worship, the council has met, and we're able to meet in person in the building again. This is going to start on Rally Sunday, September 13th, with an 8:30 traditional worship service and a 10:30 contemporary worship service. There are precautions being made in those worship services, including masks. We'll also do very intentional spacing and a variety of other things to try to keep people as safe as possible. This is the first time, of course, that we have had public worship in this building for about 5 months, and a big step, and we're excited about doing it. And yet, everybody is in different places about what their comfort level is. If you have any kind of underlying or pre-existing conditions, we still encourage you to stay home. In those vulnerable populations, you'll still have worship available online, radio, and television during that time. Again, those in-person, in-building worship services are starting on Sunday, September 13th. In terms of weddings and funerals, the building is available as of now for those things. With that said, it's with celebration and sorrow that I announce the passing of Joan Savalson, whose funeral was last week, a longtime member of Our Savior's Lutheran Church. And we keep all of Joan's family in our thoughts and prayers. And recently on Monday, the passing of Casey Berg, 39 years old, a lifetime member of this church. She is loved and will be missed forever. It's the daughter of Kim Fulstrom, and we keep Kim and Kelly and JC, all of that family, in our thoughts and prayers as they continue to grieve. There's a visitation and a prayer service right here at Our Savior's tonight, visitation from 5 to 7 and a family service at 7 o'clock. Tomorrow on Monday is the funeral at 10:30, and so we continue to keep all of Casey Berg's family in our thoughts and our prayers. Pastor Julie, is there any other announcements that you have to make?
I don't believe so. Thank you.
And a few other things about children and youth ministries. They'll be starting in September as well. We're still working out the details of exactly what that's going to look like. And we'll communicate as soon as we have more information about that. Well, in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world, we are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, and to celebrate God's calling among us. As a community gathered in the enlightenment of the Holy Spirit, we are here to speak on behalf of the whole church and to extend God's blessing to Pastor Julie Johnson as she steps into a new chapter of ministry at the TNT Parish.
Some of you may have the practice when you have devotions at home or a meeting or any kind of worship of lighting a candle or candles. The lighting of the candle is a reminder to us that whenever we gather, that the Holy Spirit is here with us, among us. You may have heard Pastor Joe or I mention a breath prayer that Pastor Joe and I shared just about every service that before we began. It's just simply taking a breath, and you may have some prayers that you say silently, or you just welcome the Holy Spirit. And so I invite you, as a way of all of us preparing for this time of worship, to join in a breath prayer. Let us pray and take a breath. We pray in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen.
God, our Creator, God, the Son who saves us, God, the Spirit placed upon us, be with you all, and also with you. Beloved, let us rejoice in the presence of God who unites us in the promise of the Holy Spirit and calls us forth in service. Thanks be to God. We'll sing together our gathering song, Praise the One Who Breaks the Darkness. And if you have an ELW hymnal at home, it's hymn number 843.
Praise.
It's from Proverbs chapter 3. Coincidentally, I think this is a passage that Amanda spoke on. You may have caught that earlier this week online. Trust God from the bottom of your heart. Don't try to figure out everything on your own. Listen for God's voice in everything you do, everywhere you go. He's the one who will keep you on track. Don't assume that you know it all. Run to God. Run from evil. From the 8th chapter of Romans, the 28th verse. We can be sure that every detail in our lives of love for God is worked into something good. The last reading from the first chapter of Ephesians. When I heard of the solid trust you have in the Lord Jesus and your outpouring of love to all the followers of Jesus, I can't stop thanking God for you. Every time I prayed, I think of you and give thanks. Here ends these readings. Grace and peace to you today in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For those of you who are joining us with this worship service on the radio, I'm holding up a picture of a frog. Today I want us to talk about those times in our lives that are frog times. Now you might be wondering, what do I mean by that? Is it that we're surprised sometimes when a frog hops in front of us? No. Is that we dress up in green and speak frog, ribbit ribbit? No, that's not it. Before I explain what I mean by the frog moment, first I want you to think about those times in your life when you feel lost. You don't feel like you have control of the situation. You might be afraid or anxious. You're not able to get done what you want to get done, what you need to get done. You don't have the power, you don't have the capability. The plans that you've made, they're all washed away. And you wonder, now what? The world has turned upside down. Well, we have certainly been living in those kind of times. The forefront of many of our minds is wondering, what is it going to be like when classes begin from preschool up to universities? These are the frog moments or times in our lives when we fully rely on God. F-R-O-G. Fully rely on God. And I'm borrowing this acronym from Pastor Nancy Nyland, who was a speaker at our Eastern North Dakota Synod Assembly a few years ago. Frog moments. The times when we can't rely on ourselves because we just don't have what is needed. And so we lean on God. We rely on God for what is needed, for strength or whatever is needed in those frog moments. We hang on tight to the hand of Jesus. The words from Proverbs are good to hear. We don't have to figure everything out on our own. That's a relief. We listen to God's voice. We listen for God's word to us. First of all, that God is with us, and so we listen, whether it is in prayer or God's word comes to us through scripture or through the voices of those around us. We don't need to know everything, and that's a relief, that we can rely on God. The last 2 months have certainly been a frog moment in my life, not just because of COVID-19, but due to the circumstances beyond my control, due to circumstances beyond anyone and everyone's control, but changes had to happen. We might not like it, we might not want it, but changes are necessary. And if the changes are made, that would be unfaithful to make some changes. So, which resulted in my decision to be open to a different call. and that meant leaving Hillsborough. And as Pastor Joe said, there's a lot of grief with that. None of us imagine the world as it is now, as we live our lives in this pandemic. 4 years ago, when I was invited to interview to be called as pastor, and yet we find ourselves again in a time of change, a time of fully relying on God. And now, after a couple of months, we find ourselves in a good place, that God works in and through all kinds of life situations, even change that we didn't anticipate or didn't plan for, that God can work in and through even those life situations. And so I have now accepted a different call to a three-point parish in Foreman, Rutland, and Havana, North Dakota in Sargent County. And many of you have heard that I'm going back home. I'll be serving a congregation where I was baptized, confirmed, and ordained. And I know a lot of people in the other congregations, and so I'm excited to be going back home. And I think I'm going to probably learn how to play pinochle a lot better, because both my brothers live there, and that is an expectation on their part. And I'm excited about what God is doing in this parish, the TNT parish, and doing ministry with those people, God's people. And I'm excited for Our Saviors Lutheran Church, of the excellent people on staff now at Our Saviors Lutheran Church. Our Saviors, I can guarantee you that you are in God's hands, and God will use these good people to lead you, to do ministry with you. But our frog moments in life are not limited to just those times when we feel that life is out of control, we might feel lost or afraid. Really, each and every day is a frog day. Each day that we need to fully rely on God, because there are things every day that we cannot control, that we cannot do for ourselves, to fully rely on God every day, to listen to what God is calling us to do that day. What mission? How to be part of God's expression of love, be part of bringing a word of hope and assurance and strength to somebody else. That to rely fully on God every day for forgiveness, the assurance of salvation, the promise of resurrection, that God brings life out of death. All yesterdays, all tomorrows, and today are days to fully rely on God. Amen.
You are perfect in all of your ways.
Thanksgiving for Pastor Julie Johnson. Pastor Julie, 4 years ago, you were called to serve at Our Savior's Lutheran Church in Hillsboro, North Dakota. On September 1st, 2016, you began your call among us, and on September 18th, you were installed. During this time, you have proclaimed God's word, baptized and taught, announced God's forgiveness, and presided at the Lord's table. With the gospel, you have comforted us in times of sickness and trouble and at the death of our loved ones. Sharing our joys and sorrows, you have been important to our life together. In our service at Our Savior's Lutheran Church in Eastern North Dakota Synod, and in God's mission to the whole world. As you prepare to enter into a new chapter of ministry, as pastor at Trinity Lutheran Church in Foreman, Norland Lutheran Church in Rutland, and Trinity Lutheran Church in Havana, we say farewell, and we pray for God's blessing. People of God, you promise to continue to pray for Pastor Julie in her next chapter of life, and do you send her forth in joy and in hope? We do, and we give thanks to God for our ministry together. Pastor Julie, do you recognize and accept the conclusion of your call as pastor at Our Savior's Lutheran Church?
I do, and I give thanks to God for our ministry together.
In his letter to the Philippians, the Apostle Paul writes, "I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you. Because of your sharing in the gospel, from the first day until now, I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work among you will bring you to completion in the day of Jesus Christ." The laying on of hands. And I invite people from home or the radio or wherever you're watching this worship service to extend a hand out to Pastor Julie. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the work and witness of your servant, Julie, who has enriched this congregation and brought gladness to family and friends. Now bless and preserve her at this time of transition. Day by day, guide her and give her what is needed. Friends to cheer her way and a clear vision to which you are now calling her. By your Holy Spirit, be present in her pilgrimage, that she may travel on the road together with the one who is the way, the truth, and the life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You have been a blessing to this congregation, to our synod, to the larger church, and to the world. We now bless you as you enter a new phase of life and continue to be a blessing. Go with love, go with joy, go with peace. The Spirit of God goes with you now. Amen. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, you have blessed this congregation and community, the greater church, with the blessing of Pastor Julie. We thank you for the work that you have done in and through her in this place and in this world. Lord, we pray that you bless her in this transition, that you walk with her in this time of change, that you continue to work through her compassion and care and the gifts that you have given her for ministry. Lord, we pray that she continues to answer this call for the sake of the gospel. Lord, we also pray for this congregation in a time of transition and change. We pray for the congregation as it grieves the change and Pastor Julie's transition. We pray that you bless the new staff of this congregation and that your work continues to be done in and through this staff and congregation. Lord, we also pray for all of the people who are in need today, those who are hungry, those who are thirsty, those who are injured or ill. We pray for those who are grieving. We pray for the family and friends of Jones Volson, the family and friends of Casey Bird. And Lord, above all else, we give thanks. We give thanks for the life that has been shared, and we give thanks for the life to come in your glorious kingdom. A gift given through your Son, Jesus Christ, as we pray together, as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Now receive a blessing. This is one of my most favorite things to do as a pastor. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now go in peace, serve the Lord, helping people experience the love of God. And we'll have our sending song.
Well, before we sing that sending song, just a couple of things. First of all, on behalf of me, Amanda and I, and the rest of the staff, we just want to express a very heartfelt thank you. You are a wonderful colleague and a wonderful friend and a wonderful pastor. And we've been blessed to get to know each other better, and a friendship that I have no doubt will last forever. And I'm thankful that we're still in the same synod and get to continue to be colleagues, because you are a treasured gift in our heart. That scripture that you read from Proverbs talks about what is written on the tablet of our heart. And Pastor Julie, your work, your personality, who you are as a child of God and who you are as a person is written on our hearts. On behalf of the congregation, we have a couple of gifts for you. Amanda, if you wouldn't mind handing those. Of course, a card from the congregation, but then also a couple of things that are very specific. And these have been crafted by a local craftsman, Lee Erickson, a member of this church. And that, of course, you can see is a heart. And this, of course, is the Our Savior's Lutheran Church cross. And we hope that you carry these with you in your life and ministry, and that we too are written on your heart. When you see them, know that you are loved and supported. I'd like to give you an air hug because we're still socially distancing. This is normally where I'd give you a hug.
This is a difficult thing. You're not able to shake hands, give hugs, or, this is thank you. Not a wind chime?
No wind chime. No.
That's an inside joke that I don't know.
We've given pastors who are taking other calls and in transition, there was a stretch where we gave wind chimes. There was a stretch where there were six pastors in 1 year, and I'm the only one still here from that six, so there were five wind chimes in that year. No, this was personalized, and again, Pastor Julie, we love you, and thank you for all of your work, and pray for all of the blessings for this church.
Thank you.
Our sending song is You Never Let Go.
Perfect love is casting out fear.
Extend a hand to Pastor Julie as we give her a farewell blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. God bless. Thank you for joining us today. Go in peace.